Do you want to go first, or should I?
Yeah, what, should we like switch off who answers first,
or like?
Hi, I'm Sean Casey.
And I'm Caitlin Casey.
And we're graduating with the class of 2023. I like to credit you.
We grew up in a town called Granger, Indiana. It's right outside of South Bend, which is a bigger Indiana city.
It's me and Caitlin, and then our little sisters are twins as well. So two sets of twins. Not many people go to Stanford from where we grew up. So having Caitlin here to kind of curb that isolation and remind me of home and keep me grounded, I think has been one of the most profoundly positive parts of my Stanford experience. When I first came to Stanford, I didn't really know what I wanted to do. I kind of, you know, jumped around to a bunch of different things. I'd done physics in high school. I tried to be a computer science major for a little bit there, as is tradition. Then my mayor, our mayor, ran for president during our freshman year. So I took two quarters off before it was cool to work on his campaign, and that totally changed the trajectory of my life. I loved it. I loved the people. I loved the work. I loved how I felt when I woke up in the morning. After that, I took a pivot into the realm of politics and policy. I was the co-director of Stanford Votes, and kind of flowing from that, I worked with a friend on the ASSU pass the Democracy Day legislation through the Faculty Senate. Democracy Day is the academic holiday that the university observes on Election Day. So that's kind of been the through line for my time at Stanford outside of class. Just generally trying to engage people in the public-spirited mission of Stanford.
I think a lot of my Stanford journey, especially outside of the classroom, has just been doing things that I enjoy doing as a person, but it's gotten to take me to some amazing places and meet fantastic people. I joined Greek Life and I got to meet amazing, strong women who also helped guide me. And then I got this really cool opportunity where I had a lot of friends on the field hockey team and they happened to be down that year, a goalie. And while I had never played field hockey and also never been a goalie, our coach told us to go find someone who would be crazy enough to go do this. And I fit the bill pretty perfectly. That was really fun. I got to do the D1 experience. And then I kind of went back to all the things that I loved before after I was done with that. I don't think any one person could even do a tenth of the things that are possible to do here at Stanford. Sean and I had like super different paths here. I have loved every moment of it. I don't think I would change a thing. To the class of 2023, I would say, well, thank you for welcoming me. I was, you know, not supposed to be with you guys. But also just that the world is like very big. There are tons of unknowns. You really can't go wrong with passion and kindness, and all of you guys possess that in spades.
I think I'm just really grateful to have come here when I did and shared this experience with the people I was able to share it with. I like the quote that's like, it's gonna be okay in the end, and if it's not okay, it's not the end.